Hello everybody, we are in another session and this is a session called Pandemic Lessons, Learning Has No End. Pandemic. Now what is pandemic? It is a problem which is caused by either disease or any other natural catastrophe. A problem can be created or discovered. Remember, you can create a problem or you can do a research to discover a problem. There are problems which are created by man, others are by nature. When you don't know where you are, then that means you don't know where you are come from, and you will never know where you are headed to. When pandemic happens, there are critical lessons that we must learn. It's very critical to learn this, that we have been facing pandemic in different years. We had a pandemic in 1914. Then we had another one in 1918, which went to 1920. Then we had a World War II, which happened in 1945. Now, each and every pandemic has brought forth critical lessons. When you fail to learn, you fail to grow. In any problem, become a student and you will grow. Lessons. There lies silver lining in every pandemic. The following are lessons we learn from any problem that we face. Physical lessons, that's number one. Two, psychological lessons, that's number two. Three, social lessons. Then four, economical lessons. Five, spiritual lessons. So these are lessons that we learn from each and every pandemic that comes our way. Each and every problem that comes our way. So we start with number one, physical lessons. There are lessons which we face in our day in, day out. They are directly affecting our life. They include the following. East or West, always best. Every pandemic will bring a clear message that home is our best place to be. Number two, no movements. In every pandemic, we have seen lockdown. No movement of goods, no movement of people. Number three, basic hygiene matters. Washing hands, sanitizing, wearing masks. These are physical actions that we practice in our daily life. You belong to one physical location at a time. That means if a lockdown happens or if a curfew happens, then you have no way of moving from where you are. If it's not your home, you make it your home. Number two lesson is physical lesson. The lessons that emanate from the way we think and do things in our day-to-day activities. They include the following. We think on how we can improve our welfare. So this is the time people are thinking, how can we improve our welfare? Two, we think on how we can protect our families. Everybody is busy looking on how their families can be protected. We think on how we can reach the needy. People begin caring and sharing. We think on how we can fix the very problem in the near future if they happen. So meaning that we focus on the future. Remember, in different pandemics, we have seen nations, governments coming together and striking a balance, coming up with an organization. Like UN came in place in 1945 because of what? It was a pandemic. We think on how we can improve our health system. We think on how we can improve our education system. We think on how we can become self-reliant. We think on innovative solutions to life. Now, that is what lessons we learn from a pandemic. Number number three lesson is social lesson. The lesson here comes out of how we relate to each other. The social life changes completely. They include no more handshake. That is the trend of the day. We are told if you shake, you transfer a disease, and especially in COVID-19. No more hugging. People are used to the lifestyle of hugging each other, but no more hugging. Social distancing becomes a reality. Keeping a distance from each other. We are seeing this. It will happen in our institutions. It will happen in the transport sector. It will happen in our families. Washing hands and sanitizing is a way of life. Believe me not, this is now the real thing. Cleanliness is next to godliness. Wearing masks is a must. No mask, no service. That is the trend. That is what is happening now. You can't go to the supermarket without a mask. You can't board any transport system without a mask. Family is the first priority. Burial procedures is a family affair. Entertainment is exclusively to family only. So you enjoy your entertainment at your own home. No more public gathering. Sports, no more. Campaigns, no more. So things have changed. So in every pandemic, it comes with a different things, different lifestyles, economic lessons. The pandemic has made the economy to struggle. Any time problem occurs, an economy suffers. Right now, we are trying to strike a balance between economy and life. Other nations are saying we are coming back, irrespective of COVID-19. We are coming back. So you strike a balance between economy and life. If you treasure life, you will keep safe, stay at home. If you treasure economy, you will open up your businesses. Due to lockdown, every country is trying to keep the economy moving. There's no movement of people. The countries are focusing on improving their production. The countries are focusing on producing their own. And this is a very important lesson. Developing nations are now looking at, they used to get things from developed nations. But in such a pandemic, it has forced countries to produce their own. Producing your own product. Don't focus on importing. Focus on home production. Buy home, produce home, buy home. The countries are establishing stimulus packages. So stimulus packages to rescue the economy. The countries are raising funds from well-wishers, something that has never happened. Now it is happening. Nations are raising funds through people, through institutions. Countries are packaging themselves by creating fund reserve for future pandemics. So it has made countries now to think, we need to have a reserve so that in case a pandemic happens, we'll be able to feed the country. The nations are coming together to fight the unknown enemy, meaning that this is when countries focus on togetherness, oneness, in fighting the unknown enemy. Scientists are coming together. Academicians are coming together. Financial industries are coming together. The realignment action between countries. So countries are realigning themselves. The exposed weakness of countries depend on wholly on others for production. So it has exposed the weakness of countries depending on others' countries. The countries are looking inward and stop relying on the outward. That means we now look on our own. We look at creating employment in our country and producing our own products. The time of building capacity of in all sectors in a country becomes a reality. So a country now begins looking at building capacity in learning institutions, building capacity in the health sector, building capacity in agriculture sector, building capacity in financial sector, now it becomes a reality. The new entrepreneurs will mushroom the market. That means when the pandemic takes place, now we are talking about the non-essential services are staying at home. The essential services are moving up and down. So meaning that digitalization becomes a reality. New way of doing business, virtual meetings, online shopping. Why? Is because when you stay at home, you need to eat, you need to do business, you need to generate income. So these are economical factors, lessons that we are learning from pandemic. The next one is spiritual lessons. Now, in spiritual lessons, the church where people gather is no more. There's no gathering of believers. The message is very clear, which includes one, where two or three are gathered, there the Lord is. So meaning that the gathering is now reduced to family affairs. The behavior of getting used to congregation service has been reduced to person fellowship. Time of establishing true worshippers is now, because the Bible talks about the true worshippers. The Lord is looking for the true worshippers, and now is. The gospel is now spreading through social media like never before. When you go to Facebook, you see preachers preaching the word. The gospel is being spread. When you go to WhatsApp, you meet with the gospel. When you go to TV stations, you meet with the gospel. Keep your heart for this. There is where life oozes. So this is the time believers will be securing their hearts for life. Home fellowship is up there. It's a reality. Wedding is now a family affair. People draw close to God, unlike before. So people are now closing to God, because when somebody hears of death, he'll always be scared. Heaven and hell becomes a reality. Uprise in heresies and false prophecies. Now we are hearing this is the end of the world, but in reality, it's not. Why? Is because these are not the signs. It is biblically stated, the end of the world, how the end will come. So these are critical lessons that you learn in time of pandemic. So the key lessons, I've done the summary. The key lessons, number one, when pandemic strikes, it is not a respecter of color, race, power, riches, poverty, short and tall, fat and slim, young and old, literate and illiterate, developed and developing nation, wise and unwise. All will face the same fate. People become more caring and sharing. You realize people are now caring and sharing. People are giving out their monies to the needy one, those who are living in mouth to hands life. Personal discipline is inculcated. Now, this is time when people are becoming responsible. Responsibility is now a key thing. Now, when you look at the industrial world, the motor companies have been converted to produce ventilators. The cloth factories have been converted to produce PPIs and masks. And stadiums have become hospitals. Schools have become quarantine centers, and home have become offices. So these are critical lessons. There is a silver lining in every pandemic. After COVID-19, we'll have a new development within and beyond the country and continent. These are the lessons we must learn. Thank you. Be informed.